Dragon Quest Builders 2 again. So that we can continue some of these scenes that we've been playing for a while now. So that way they have enough food. Tougher walls until like later on in the game. Yeah, I forgot I created the under water portion for the sugar cane. How's everyone doing, by the way? I hope you guys are doing okay. Things down here.
Thank you.
I need one more. I need to get two more, so I need to grab a few more of them. We have enough to build another chest. I think we can have up to like 99 pieces in each section. Let's see if we can find more dry grass and then what are some of the other missions we have to do? Grow some sugar cane. I don't have enough dry grass to create another scarecrow. I might just forget how to run in this game because, as I said, I've been kind of going back and forth between playing this game with you guys, the second one, and then playing the first one by myself until at least we get through this one together. And then the first one, I haven't found the option of being able to run. Because I don't think there is an option. And a few of the scarecrows will be able to take back to the island. Well, hopefully you guys can hear me better now. I was able to find something to lift up the mic I use. Yeah. Do something else with these, what are they called, the wooden grating. ship has that many issues. Go down a little level. Change out. Let's see, where did I put the sugar cane? I can't remember. I've seen this other one, like, I seriously don't remember.
Thank you.
did I place it over here? That's what it is. Boy, can't. My brain doesn't want to work half the time. So I need two more seedlings after the sugar cane. The thing with sugarcane is they have to be in water. And I think tomatoes too, I can't remember. Once we get there, we'll figure it out. Our sugar cane has sprouted. It looks like you got the hang of making fields and water just as expected from our resident builder. Maybe it's my imagination, but the sugar cane already smells so lovely and sweet. I bet we could make some really delicious food out of it. And only that I could stick a piece up my nose and enjoy the wonderful sweet smell every minute of every day. Yeah. You'd be better served by sticking sugar cane seedlings in your ears. Come in the morning, you'll find a pair of fully grown pants spread from your nostrils. I just, don't put your nose out of joint. Well, now that we know how to grow sugar cane, we can plant as much as we like, and best of all, we don't have to spend time watering it. We've got three types of crops on the grow now, but we still need two more. If I find out where to find any more seeds, you'll be the first to know. So we've got one said kid who would put sugar up the nose, but then the guy who would actually literally use it for torture. Yo, Jimmy, what's up? thought you were kind of looking at kind of like worn out. Well, I'm totally stoked that the farm's coming along as well. Gas these fields and crops and stuff are seriously lit. But the whole place seems like a bad boom with goo. So, she's saying that, well, you guys probably get the gist of it. Like, she's saying the place is reeking badly. I have to, like, hold my breath to stop it. Stop blowing chunks in my own mouth. Gross. Can you help me out? Can, like, build us some kind of building or whatever? I know you got mad skills. Can't you strip all the blueprint for a bathroom and then build it? Like, basic bathroom isn't enough for a girl like me. You gotta finesse a place. Make it super stylish. I don't care where you put it. Just lay that blueprint down wherever you think looks cool, okay? I don't know why. Every time like we talk to like Britney soldiers, I like 60 feet old with the language she uses. I think y'all get at that certain point where there are new like terms that are used in place of like the old ones that the previous generation used. Like that one SpongeBob episode where Mr. Krabs tries to use that lingo, with the old lingo with the younger generation. I think I'm gonna have to extend the ceiling of this room too. Thank you. character here is gonna need more food. Capture card recording mode in the new PlayStation 5. Rather, they kept it for all of the different ones they had to make over the past few years. I don't know, but that was something that wasn't really available in previous consoles. Was to be able to record full-on videos and have it saved. How much of you need of which item. I don't know. this stuff and... First playthroughs of this game, I had like this bathhouse right over there, like by the bell, and every time the monsters would come, it would be destroyed. I have to get the... I think I have like the trigger cane. Just in case, because... It's been, well, almost like an hour. OMG, things that's... The bathroom's just like you drew it up, thanks. Bam, now everyone can scrub off the dirt and grime they're covered in. Most importantly, start to smell a little less grubby. Going to have a bath like every day from now on. I hope you don't try to peek in on me. Only weirdos do that. And perverts. No, but seriously, don't do that. It's way uncool. Don't even think about getting any shady ideas. Because if you do get your loss, beat you up. Beat you to a pulp. No, that would not be a bad idea to have someone like Norbus do all the beatings. For people to do that. Alright. Oh, Gemini, my phone grows more splendid by the day. I know that. Become something of a brother for you, Tia, and I'm proud to have you as a surrogate daughter. I know you have not become, but so you have not yet seen your full potential, my girl. And not only could your building skills grow even greater, but so could ours. I suggest you speak with our residents and aid them all in whatever you can do. They may only have gratitude to offer you, but what could be better for you? For the appreciative energy into the builders, both thus improving their powers and summoning unique allies to your aid. Now, Gedrin, as our fellow townspeople, how you can help them fulfill their requests and ring the builders' bell once more. Hello, Gedrin. I see you've been sitting at a remarkable rate lately. Since you showed no sign of wishing to repent, perhaps you might do me a favor. I'm sure my full residents and I could be glad of your 10 gold if you caught any towel in it, and if you... What's that? Why 10 would they not be more pleased with a larger one? It's a little difficult to relax and do what must be done if one is sitting in a wide open space. I really think the room should be as small as possible. So. To reiterate, that's a tiny room with a spotty tail rail. Build that for us and we will be able to, you know what. Yes, I get what you're saying, Jake. Hello, Jimmy. I must say, ever since you brought us to your farm, life has been just one surprise after another for me. Everyone is growing crops and indulging in the fruits of creation with great big smells on their faces. Does no breeder expect the children to park on? Really not a sad one. Are you still pretending to hate building? You're not fooling anybody. Oh, you're right, Lillian. She's seen everyone growing these crops is making me hungry. I want you to make something to eat. Jim and I won't have to have it on the advice that you put wheat on the bonfire turns some blue rather delicious. But please, John, can you make me bread for me? Yes. Alright, so this room's not tiny enough for Clayton's bathroom toilet request. Bigger. Right, these gentlemen, we just keep getting better and better. We can even handle planting seeds now. If you want us to plant some seeds for you, stick them in a chest. Then you just have to pick who you want to plan by. Put it on the scarecrow and well, that's not all. The sound of the bullet has summoned some more people. Our farm just keeps growing and growing. I just leave the episode here, guys. After the save. And then we'll just continue the next one.